So Goldie and Ida have followed them to Mel's diner to check things out. Goldie turned her face away from the window glass and thrust up her pocketbook to obscure any view of Ida. She wasn't sure, but she didn't think Rachel saw her. What in the world are you doing, you crazy person? Put that thing down before you hurt someone. Shh, Ida, shh. Why should I shh? Goldie pointed at Rachel's retreating form and then at Julia, who was just exiting the diner. Oh, Ida said in a whisper Goldie was sure could be heard from 3 blocks away. Ida turned up the lapel of her fur coat and hid behind it. Several moments later, she asked, are they gone yet? I think so, Goldie answered. She peeked out from around Ida. The coast is clear. That was a close one. Tell me about it. Almost gave me another heart attack. Are you okay? I never should have let you talk me into this mashugana caper, Goldie said. Ida was pale and breathing heavily. Are you kidding? And let you have all the fun? Never. We should go. Not so fast, Ida said. She put a restraining hand on Goldie's arm. What did they say? Who? Who? The girls, our granddaughters. What were they talking about? How should I know? I was out here with you, or didn't you notice? Very funny, Goldola. You were the one with your nose to the window. As bad as your hearing is, you don't read lips. No, I don't read lips. Whatever gave you that idea? Excuse me, a woman pushing a stroller pointed to Ida's walker, which took up the majority of the sidewalk. Can we get by? What? Oh, sure, sure. Ida wheeled the walker closer to the building. When the woman and baby had passed, Ida said to Goldie, we need to know what they said to each other. Well, it's too late for that now. Nonsense, Ida pointed to the server who had waited on Rachel and Julia. What about her? Grease her palm. What? Goldie asked. Ida rubbed her thumb and 2 fingers together. Pay her off, grease her palm, find out what she knows. You've lost what's left of your mind. Have I? You want to know what the girls talked about and why your Rachel ran off in such a hurry? She's the only one who can tell us. Goldie bit her lip. Should she do it? It seemed so Humphrey Bogart in the Maltese Falcon. Hello, Goldola, it's cold out here. Go in there and give that girl $5. She'll spill the beans for sure. Goldie wasn't so sure $5 would do the trick. I got a better idea. Come on. She led Ida to the front door. What are you doing? If we both go in there, she might get suspicious. Yes, because an old lady walking up and handing her $5 and asking a bunch of questions wouldn't be the least bit suspicious, Goldie said. I'm afraid that blockage you had has gone to your brain. You're not thinking clearly. Ida bristled. And I suppose you are? Watch and see. Goldie opened the door to the diner and motioned Ida to precede her inside. She stepped up to the hostess stand. Table for two, please. She saw that Rachel and Julia's table was still open. Can we have that one over there by the window? Certainly, the hostess led them to the table. What are you doing? I'm not hungry, Ida complained. Hush, for goodness sake, for once in your life, just be quiet, let me do the talking. The server approached. What can I get you, ladies? We'll have 2 cups of coffee black, Goldie said. Anything else? I thought I saw those 2 girls who sat here before us get something that looked really yummy. What was that? I'm not hungry. Goldie kicked Ida under the table. Ouch! Goldie batted her eyelashes at the server. So, what did those 2 girls who sat here before us have? 2 girls? You know, they were young and pretty, looked like movie stars if you ask me. The server gazed back toward the kitchen where the cook was yelling, order up, Zelda, sometime today. I'd have to go look at their order, and I don't have time for that. It wasn't anything special, I can tell you that. Do you want more than just coffee or not? No, Ida said. Yes, Goldie said. Which is it? The server asked. No, Ida repeated. She squinted to read the server's name tag. Zelda, is it? What we really want to know. Goldie kicked Ida under the table again, this time harder. Ida gave Goldie a murderous glare and turned her attention to Zelda. Did you overhear what the young women who just left this table 5 minutes ago were talking about? There's $5 for you in it if you tell us. The server shook her head. Zelda, you want to keep working here? Get this order. Food's getting cold. Zelda glanced back over her shoulder toward the grill. I'm coming. She returned her attention to Goldie and Ida. You two are crazy, you know that? Do you want coffee or not? I gotta go get that order or I'll get fired. So does that mean you're not gonna tell us what we wanna know? Ida persisted. Lady, I have no idea what it is you think I know, but whatever it is, I don't know it. Is that clear enough for you? Well, you don't have to be rude about it, Ida rejoined. Come on, Goldie, I can see this person doesn't want our business. Ida rose in a huff and grabbed her walker. As she maneuvered in the tight space between the crowded tables, she banged into the chair of a small boy. Undeterred, she backed up the walker, angled it slightly to the side, and shoved it through the opening again, this time successfully. Goldie lingered behind. "I'm sorry for my friend," she said to the server. "This is for your trouble." She handed her a $5 bill. "Whatever, lady." Goldie hustled to the front of the diner where Ida was ramming her walker into the glass doors, trying to get them to open. If the two of them were lucky, they wouldn't get arrested for attempted bribery or disturbing the peace or some other charge before they could get back to the safety of Shady Acres.